Hey, what's up, guys? In this video, we're going to be talking about laser detection in radar detectors. Now, whenever you guys ask me this question, it usually comes up in one of two different formats. It's either, hey, I'm looking at this particular detector. How is the laser sensitivity of this detector? And the other question is, I'm looking at maybe two different detectors. Which one is better when it comes to laser? And the answer to both of those is, it doesn't matter. Radar detector, quite frankly, is the wrong tool for the job when it comes at keeping you protected from speeding tickets when it comes to laser. What you actually want to use is an app like Waze, as well as a set of laser jammers. Now, I'm going to go into a lot more detail here in just a bit, but unlike with radar, you're not going to actually get any advanced warning with laser. By the time your radar detector goes off, a lot of times it won't even go off in the first place because these are so difficult to detect, but let's say it actually does go off when you get shot with laser. By the time this guy starts screaming, police officer's already got your speed on his laser gun, so a radar detector is not really that useful when it comes to detecting laser. The right tools are going to be Waze, which is an app you can run on your phone. People will mark where police are parked on the side of the road, so you get advanced warning so you can slow down ahead of time. And then the other tool is going to be a set of laser jammers to actually prevent the laser gun from getting a reading, and then slow down to the speed limit, quickly turn off your jammers, allow him to get your speed, and then he's like, oh, okay, cool. Doing the speed limit, we'll shoot the next car, right? So those are the correct tools for combating laser. Now, whenever I say this, people will usually either ask, you know, what's the best laser jammer? Or they'll come up with one of two objections. They'll either say, I don't want to run laser jammers because, well, it costs extra money. You've got to pay for the jammers and you have to have them installed in your car. Maybe do the install yourself or pay a professional to do it. Or maybe the other one is, hey, laser jammers are illegal where I live. They're not legal everywhere. You'll want to do more research. I've got a video talking about the legalities of laser jammers. But one of the other objections is, hey, laser jammers are illegal. So for those of you guys who are wondering about radar detectors for laser, even though it's not the right tool for the job, let's actually talk about how effective they are and go into some detail regarding sensitivity, comparisons between different detectors, and even laser testing and how different detectors compare. Now, to start us off, we need to talk a little bit about how laser works. Laser is actually very different than radar. Radar detectors are designed primarily for radar. That's why they're called radar detectors, right? The way radar works, when a police officer is using radar, he can be driving or he can be stationary, and he's shooting radar, and he's clocking oncoming traffic, and your radar detector is designed to give you advanced warning before he can get your speed so that you can slow down and respond accordingly so that by the time he's able to get your speed, you've already had some advanced warning, you've had a chance to slow down, he sees you're doing the speed limit, cool, done, right? With laser, unfortunately, you're not going to get that advanced warning. So with this one, because he's, shooting one car at a time, and because the laser beam is such a thin beam of light, it's not just blasting everywhere, and you're not going to be able to pick it up in advance the way you are with radar. The laser beam that's coming out of the car, it's a laser beam. It's very, very thin and tiny, right? It's just a thin pinpoint beam of laser. Now, the beam actually does kind of spread as it travels. It's called the beam divergence. And the divergence of this particular gun, it's very standard. It's 3 milliradians. Now, what that translates to is that thin beam of light at 500 feet away, it translates to about 18 inches, the width, the diameter of that beam. So when he's aiming at your front license plate or your grill or your headlights, it's a very small circle, and your radar detector up on your windshield is going to have a really tough time actually seeing that signal in the first place. Now, the nice thing about laser is as you start getting farther away from the laser gun, that beam is going to continue to diverge and get bigger and bigger. At 1,000 feet away, the beam is actually 3 feet wide. At 1 kilometer away, the beam is actually about 3 meters by 3 meters, so like 9 or 10 feet wide. So a lot bigger at a distance, but a lot smaller close up. So unlike radar, which is easier to pick up at close range because the signal's stronger, with laser, it's easier to pick up at a distance because the beam is bigger, right? So it's a little bit different. Now with laser, yes, you can technically sometimes pick it up in advance. That's actually known as scatter. The laser beam, it's going to get wider as it gets farther away, right? Which is really helpful for us. It's more likely that he's targeting one car, maybe the one next to it, which could be you, is getting targeted. Additionally, there's things like that laser beam could hit the car that the officer is targeting, reflect off at an angle, and maybe you pick it up as you're coming around a bend or something. So it's possible that you can pick up reflections off of vehicles coming ahead of you. Let's say, he's shooting the front of the vehicle, and, maybe there's a little bit of handshake or whatever, his laser gun comes up and he's shooting through the windshield out the back window, and you, back behind the car that he's targeting, get that advanced warning. That is known as scatter. It's extremely rare. So in no way, shape, or form is that something you'd want to rely on for protection, but it's good to know that it could happen. It's kind of like winning the lottery. It's extremely rare, but yes, technically that is possible. And there are a couple people that have reported having saves against that, just like there's a couple people who've reported winning the lottery, right? So it's not something that you're going to want to rely on for protection, but it is possible. Now, besides scatter, even though that can happen, yes, really what's going to happen is 99% of the time, you're going to get shot, and that's the point when your radar detector will alert, if it even does in the first place. Again, because that beam is so small, it's going to be very difficult for your detector to alert in the first place. Some people may want to run their radar detector lower on the windshield, but even if it does go off by that point, boom, radar detector goes off. It's basically a speeding ticket notifier, and so what most people will actually do is run their radar detector high. It does make it tougher for laser detection, but it does actually give you better radar detection performance, which is really what the specialty of a radar detector is. So you want to focus it for radar and let other tools like laser jammers or Waze handle the laser side. So that's typically what you do. But anyways, let's talk about testing and how all this would work. Now, let's say you actually wanted to do the testing. We could sit here and say that, you know, a laser detector and a radar detector is not going to help you avoid a ticket, but what about for those of you guys who are wondering anyways? What if you actually are curious? Hey, you know, I get it. I need a laser jammer, but for one reason or another, I don't want one, or I'm not running one. I'm curious to see how my radar detector is going to help me. Let's talk about testing. Laser alert. Now, when it comes to testing laser sensitivity in a radar detector, that's actually quite challenging to do for a number of reasons. The first thing is when you're hand-holding a laser gun, there's going to be a little bit of vibration in the laser gun, you know, just from holding it or even your breath or your heartbeat if you're trying to be super stationary. So because of that, your laser gun is going to be moving and you're going to be targeting different areas around the car. And it's possible that, you know, on one run you were aiming lower and then another run you were aiming a little bit higher and it made it easier for the radar detector. The radar detector is more likely to alert and it'll seem like it's more sensitive, not because the detector is more sensitive, but because the testing conditions were different from run to run, right? You're like, okay, well, what if I want the same testing conditions every run? I'll just run a lot of radar detectors on my windshield at the same time, and I'll see how they compare. One of the nice things about doing this is, you know, radar detectors, you can't test radar with two radar detectors side by side because on radar, they will interfere with each other, but this is not the case on laser. I've actually done testing with multiple different radar detectors on the windshield to test for laser. However, after trying a couple different test passes with the radar detectors mounted in different locations, maybe in the center of the windshield or closer to the outside, I found that was a variable being introduced that was affecting the results, so that wasn't going to work. So you're like, okay, well, I need to have every radar detector in the same location, and I can't have the laser gun moving. So what if I put this on a tripod, and I had this guy completely stationary, not moving at all, and I drove the exact same route with every single radar detector mounted in the exact same location? That's not actually the way that police use their laser guns, at least here where I live, here in the States. They're hand-holding them. But for the sake of, you know, having controlled testing conditions, that could be an option. Additionally, there's places that maybe would use a fixed laser gun. There's like the Poliscan, which is a mobile photo LiDAR unit. It's like a laser hooked up to a camera, you drive through it, and if you're speeding, it mails you a ticket. And there's some places all across the world where they used fixed laser. So this could actually replicate real-world testing conditions, which, you know, could be valuable for some people. It wouldn't replicate what I would need, but that could be a way to control the testing conditions, and that is valuable for other people who do encounter situations like this. You could actually test this, and people have done this, and they've actually done some testing with, like, the ALPs versus the Poliscan, or versus the Blinder HP905s versus LIs and whatnot to test sensitivity, jamming capability with different angles, all this kind of stuff. So a lot of the testing has been done. But really, even if you go through all that, the result is still going to be that you need laser jammers to protect you from laser, and the radar detector is not going to help you. You know, even if you do the test and you try a bunch of different radar detectors and you're like, okay, well, one detector went off 10 feet before the other ones, or one radar detector gave me half a second of extra warning, or was 10% more sensitive, or whatever result you get, ultimately, the results are still going to be that even if you find technically one detector is a little bit more sensitive than the other, you still are not going to wind up getting any sort of reliable saves from a radar detector, even if one happens to be a little bit more sensitive than the other, you know? So we could go through all the work and testing and whatnot, but the results are still going to be that the radar detector is not helping you avoid the ticket, which is ultimately what these things are here for in the first place, not really seeing which one is more sensitive. You know, does that difference make a difference? And if the difference in sensitivity doesn't make a difference in terms of protection, who cares what the difference is? Now, if we want to talk about the most sensitive radar detector when it comes to laser sensitivity, that's going to be the Valentine 1. This is the gold standard when it comes to laser sensitivity in a radar detector. This is more sensitive than anything else. So for those of you guys who truly want laser detection, this is the best laser detector that you'll find in any radar detector. If you're looking to detect scatter, for example, this is the best one. Now, unfortunately, the issue with the V1 is the filtering is not very good. It needs to be updated, actually. So while the sensitivity is great, the thing about laser is when you get shot, you need to be on the brakes immediately. As soon as this thing starts screaming, brake, you know? Unfortunately, because the filtering is not very good, you get quite a few false alerts. Primarily, what I see when I test it is it will alert to laser-based collision avoidance systems in a variety of different modern cars, particularly Mazdas, Infinities, and Volvos. Those three brands in particular, they've got some laser systems in the front of their cars for like emergency braking. If the car ahead brakes, you'd avoid an accident, your car will start braking automatically, or laser cruise control, that kind of stuff, right? The laser transmitters built into those cars will cause the V1 to fall. So not so much some of the other radar detectors that have better filtering but less sensitivity. But what I find driving around, I get a lot of false alerts on laser, which is actually why I run with the V1 with laser turned off altogether. I don't do it with my other detectors. Everything else I leave laser turned on. But with this guy, because there's a lot of false alerts, I run with it turned off. So yes, it's the best laser detector, but no, it's not actually that helpful. Even though it's going to give you the best chance of detecting scatter and all that kind of stuff, I run with laser turned off. But for those of you guys who are wondering what's the best laser detector in any radar detector, it's the Valentine 1. So anyway, for those of you guys who are wondering about, you know, laser detection in a radar detector, that's the story. It's not really that helpful when it comes to protecting you against speeding tickets, so it's not really worth investing the time and energy in figuring out which one is a little more sensitive than the other, because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. So for those of you guys who are wondering what you actually should do, it comes down to two things. Number one, run Waze on your phone, an app like that. That's really helpful here in the States. Maybe in other countries, in other parts of the world, there's other apps or other tools that will mark you or alert you to fixed photo LiDAR locations. So using GPS, they'll say, hey, this is a location where there's a laser-based speed trap, and they'll give you advanced warning, right? Here we don't have so much of those in the States, so we use Waze, which relies on people actually marking where police officers are located. That's really helpful for laser because, unlike radar, a police officer has to be stationary to run laser. With radar, they can be driving and use radar, but with laser, they have to be stationary. And so if they're parked on the side of the road, it's very likely that after a little while, somebody will mark them on the app and let you know of an alert or a police officer up ahead, so you get the advanced warning, which is helpful. Unfortunately, Waze only gives you a quarter mile of range with the current version. Some people run older versions and change that and whatnot. But, you know, if you're looking for protection with Waze, that's a good option. Make sure that you are kind of paying attention to your phone and looking. They've made it a little bit harder to see alerts ahead, and the alert distance is a lot less. So it's not as good of a tool that it used to be, but it's still definitely helpful. It's not going to work if the police officer just arrived and hasn't been marked yet, or maybe if it's at night and nobody sees him and he's really hiding and stealthy with his lights off, right? So it's not a 100% bulletproof tool, but it's definitely a good tool, and considering it's free, I would definitely recommend Waze. I'll put the link down in the video description to where you can download it. The other tool, and really the one that I would recommend as the best tool for protecting you from laser, would be a set of laser jammers. Those are installed in your grill where the police officers are targeting, so they're great at detecting. When they detect laser, they actually transmit back to the laser gun and prevent it from getting a speed. They alert you. You slow down to the speed limit and kill your jammers really quick, within a couple seconds, and typically the jammers will actually disable after a few seconds, which is the correct way to do it. So it takes them an extra second or two to get your speed, which is actually really normal. Slow down, kill your jammers, allow them to get your speed, doing the speed limit, and you keep going, right? Now, the best tool for this is going to be, the best jammers are the Anti-Laser Priority. I'll put a link down in the video description to my review of it, installation guide, how to install them, different tools and accessories and all that kind of stuff. So all the info that you need about ALPs will be down in the video description. I'm not going to go into too much detail here because we're focused more on the radar detectors, right? But the best tools are Waze and a good set of laser jammers to help keep you protected from laser. Now, the laws actually vary from place to place, so you definitely are going to want to do a little bit of research. I'll put a link down to, in the video description to more information about the laws and all that kind of stuff. Again, I focus more on the U.S. and some in Canada as well. For you guys living overseas, over in Europe or Saudi Arabia or Australia, New Zealand, things vary greatly. So definitely do your own research for other countries. As you guys know, I focus mostly on the U.S. and a little bit on Canada. So anyways, when it comes to protection against laser jam or against laser, a radar detector is the wrong tool for the job. And yes, we could do testing to figure out which one is best and whatnot, but it's not really all that valuable to have that information, which is why you don't see a lot of the testing done. And for those of you guys wondering, how does, you know, one of the biggest questions lately is how does the R3 compare to laser, or how does it work with laser, and how does it compare to the V1, since the V1 is the gold standard? A lot of you guys have asked about that, and you know, is the answer. Get a set of laser jammers. That's actually the right tool. So information about where you can download Waze and laser jammers and all that kind of stuff will be down in the video description. And for those of you guys who have been wondering, there you go. Here's the information about how laser works. And yeah. So anyways, let me know if you have any questions. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.